You can grab some drink
and
chips.
Where are my
Yeah, only take a few at a time. Don't take them all to your desk. You can take about a handful. All right, so we are going to begin here.
Haven't seen you in forever.
All right, could I have everyone take their seats, please? For you back there, I marked the spots in the Bibles for when you are reading verses. Alright, does anyone have any prayer requests today? I have one for my friend and their church family, so please keep my friend in prayer. Anyone else? You have any prayer requests? Charlie, you have any prayer requests? Alex?
No,
any?
I don't.
Alex?
What?
Any prayer requests?
No.
Any prayer requests, Harmony? Any prayer requests? Sophia, any prayer requests?
No.
All right. Hannah, can you lead us in prayer today? All right. Thank you, Hannah. Before we continue on today, could I have everyone please grab their notebooks from up there? They should have your name on them. I forgot to take a few others out. If you need help finding them, I can help you. Alex.
Alright. This is my...
Yeah, that's your notebook.
Thank you.
How do you know?
It should have your name in it. Does anyone need any pens to write with?
No.
Yeah.
You need one? Choose one. This one's fancy. You need one, Charlie? You need one? Choose one. Choose one. All right, while you are doing that, I am going to hand out these mini papers. And at the end, I will explain what these are for. So I'm going to hand out about two of these to everyone each. We're going to talk about what they are for at the end of the lesson. There's two there. Hannah. All right, now let's continue on here. So if you could write in the top of your notebooks, fruit of the Spirit, what is faith? Because that's the title for today's lesson. I'll give everyone a moment to write that. Huh? You need a pen? Your catch, Hannah? All right, so I'll give you guys a moment to write that.
What? Got problems?
You got it, Beth? Did you get it, Charlie?
Sounds like squishy.
Did you get it, Harmony? Did you get Taya? I can always count on Sophia to get it right down. What is faith? You got it down, Hannah?
I'm slow writing.
It's okay. You can take your time. Doesn't have to be super fancy writing. I don't care. Today for the notebooks, we will not have questions at the end. I'm just giving you guys the notebooks today so you can take notes while I'm teaching of things you would like to keep in mind. Because once these notebooks are full, you guys are going to be taking these home with you. Except for the grads. The grads are going to be taking them home this year because they're no longer going to be with us, sadly. Because they're going off to college and stuff.
You're grade 12, right, Hannah?
Yeah, she's a grad, and so is Baileyan, but he's on a trip now. All right, now we are going on to our next part, preview. And reminder, if you want to take any notes during the lesson, you can go ahead and do that. So The seventh fruit of the Spirit is faith, or as it is called in many other translations of the Bible, faithfulness. Now, does anyone know, after your own experience, what faith means? If you don't want to share out loud, you can write it down in your notebook, too.
You're committed.
Yeah.
You know when Peter walked on water?
Mm-hmm. Oh, like that? Yeah, he had faith. You can give Alex a candy, and you can give yourself a candy, too, for that. Those are really good answers, by the way. All right. So the book of Hebrews contains a whole chapter about faith, and we are about to dig into that chapter about faith. Now, can I get a volunteer to read this out loud?
No.
And you can also just write the verse down in your notebooks, too. Anyone want to read this? To get a candy for it.
Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
All right, you can grab a candy for that, Alex.
Yep.
And you can also just write the top thing up here, Hebrews 11:1, in your notebooks, if you'd like to.
I'm gonna move my bags here.
According to this verse, what is the definition of faith? Anyone want to take any guesses? Yeah.
We like to have the utmost hope. Not hope. Something like you're really passionate about.
Yeah, that's really good. All right. And you guys can get a candy for that. Can you give her a candy for that? So here's what it says. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, just like Hannah and Sophia said. The evidence of things we cannot yet see with our own eyes. So there, in Hebrews 11, there are many examples of people who had faith, and I'm just about to read you some of these examples. And if you recognize any of these names, if you read the Bible before, you can raise your hand. All right, Abel is from verse 4. Does anyone recognize that name, Abel?
Like Abel.
Johnny Abel.
No.
No.
Like Abel. Like he's a brother, right?
I think so.
Isaac?
Remember.
Is that Abraham's son?
I think so. I'm trying to remember.
Cain and Abel.
And then this is a... Great. This next... Cain and Abel. This next one is someone that a lot of people probably already know. Noah, verse 7. Most of you probably know Noah, right? Noah and the ark.
He's the dude that was blind, right?
The dude.
No, he's the dude who built the ark. Most of you probably heard the story of Noah and the Ark, right?
No.
Did you ever hear the story of Noah and the Ark? Some of it. All right. And then there's Abraham, verse 8. Has everyone ever heard of Abraham? Abraham and Isaac?
Yeah. Isaac and
Abel. And then we have Sarah, which was a woman. Sarah, verse 11. Does anyone know who Sarah was?
Like, wasn't that Abraham's wife?
Yeah, Abraham's wife. Jacob, verse 21. Does anyone know who Jacob is?
His son? Abraham's son.
Yeah, Abraham's son.
Jacob and Esau.
Yeah. Jacob and Esau. And we have Joseph, verse 22. I'm pretty sure most of you heard the story of Joseph and the coat of many colors and how his brothers treated him. And then we have Moses, verse 23. I'm pretty sure most of you heard the story of Moses about, you know, how he helped the Israelites escape from Egypt. Yeah.
He's the dude with the rainbow
cobra. And then there's Samson, verse 32. And I'm pretty sure most of you guys also heard about the story of Samson, about a big, strong guy.
No.
He's the guy in the lion's pit, right?
Huh?
No, he's the dude.
And then there's David, verse 32. Some of you probably heard about David, right? Who was a king once. And then that is some of the people that are listed in the Bible for having faith. The Bible is full of people whose lives we can study as lives as examples of faith and faithfulness. Now let's go on to our parable part 5. Does anyone recognize any of those names?
Yeah.
Yeah, you probably recognize most of them because they were pretty faithful people and a lot of people probably heard about them. Yeah, Esther was pretty faithful too. It's just listing some of the people in the story. Do you know why each of these men and women of God were known for having faith? Yeah, that's a pretty good guess.
They believed when there was bad things happening.
Like, we could use Abraham for it.
Because they weren't unfaithful.
Exactly.
Wait, that guy, what's his name? He's the dude that was like, he lost his whole family and stuff.
Oh, Joe.
Joseph?
No. Job. Job.
Joe Mama.
Because he didn't give up on God, even when things looked bad. Even when his wife was saying, just shame God and die. Just curse him and die. I mean, yeah, the only people he had left told him just curse God and die, but he didn't. He decided to be faithful to God even through the hard times. Even when he lost almost all his kids, almost all his family, almost lost everything. Jesus told a parable that illustrates faith and faithfulness in Matthew 25. So this next part is a bit long, so I broke it up a bit. Can I get someone to read this first part?
Them, and one he gave 5 talents, and to another he gave 1, to each according to his own ability. And immediately he went on a journey, and he who had received 5 talents and traded with them made another 5 talents. And likewise, he who had received 2 gained 2 more also. But he who had received 1 went and dug in the ground and hid his lord's money.
Sophia, can you give her candy for reading that?
No.
Thank you, Hannah. All right. So what is the talent that is referenced in this parable?
Money.
Money, yes. Yeah, that's a pretty good guess.
Hey,
so here's an illustration from a Bible document here. It says a talent was measurement of weight equaling 3,000 shekels, or approximately 65 pounds. One talent of silver was worth even more than 50 years' wages. Now imagine having to work 50 years. That would be a lot of years to work for someone, right?
I mean, that's what getting a job is.
Yeah.
Until you die.
And then,
not
until you die. And then one talent of gold is worth even more. All right. What should be the actions of an employer who has faith that her boss will return? So how could she show that she has faith that her boss will one day return, even though others have doubt?
She stays positive.
Still keep working?
Yeah.
Double her efforts.
Yeah. You guys can get a candy for that? Sifa, can you please hand them out? Oh, okay. So what it says here is she should continue to faithfully do her duties, even while the boss is away. Not just be lazy and sit there and be like, my boss is never coming back. I'm not going to do my work because I don't believe he's coming back. Why do you think the servant with 1 talent buried it? Was he afraid? Did he not want to show others that he only had 1 talent? Did he not have faith that it would grow? Does anyone have any guesses? You have a guess already?
He didn't want to lose it.
Yeah. Stephanie, can you give her another candy for that?
Did she say Hera?
No, I said Hannah. All right. So this next part is the rest of the part of that one scripture. Can I get another volunteer to read this?
I vote Harmony.
Harmony, you want to read it?
Oh.
Go ahead.
After a long time, the lord of those servants came and settled accounts with them. So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them. His lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful over a few things. I will make you a ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. He also, who had received 2 talents, came and said, Lord, you delivered to me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents beside them. His Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter the joy of your Lord.
Thank you, Harmony. You can grab a candy for reading that.
Two.
All right, can I get another volunteer to read this?
Sophia.
Who wants to read it?
Okay.
Do you want to read it, Sophia?
Yeah, sure.
Actually, you can grab one more because that was a long verse. So you can grab two after you're done reading this. All right, go ahead, Sophia. Thank you, Sophia. You can take two candies for that. All right. What was the Lord's response to the servant with who doubled their talents?
He said, good job.
Yeah. And he also said, I will make you ruler over many things. Sophia, can you give him a candy for that?
No.
The Lord said to the servant who buried his talent, would have been better off doing what exactly?
Nothing.
Yeah. You can give another candy for that, Alex. What did the Lord do to the servant who buried his talents?
He got more talents.
No, he got them taken away.
I said that.
Because he wasn't faithful and he didn't try to grow his talents. He was afraid, so he decided to bury them into the ground. What is the message of Jesus' parable of the talents? Anyone have any guesses? What the messages that Jesus is trying to tell us?
Stay strong. Don't be unfaithful. Stay faithful. And don't give up.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. You can get two candies for that, Alex. Can you hand him two candies, Sophia? We must have faith that one day Jesus is coming back. While we wait, we should be faithful to use what he's given us. God will one day reward us for being faithful. So we need to try our best to be faithful to God, even through the hard times, even when we lose everything, even when your best friend decides to go away from you because you believe in God and they don't want to, so they go away. What are some things God has given you that you should use faithfully for him? And if you don't want to, talents. If you don't want to answer this out loud, you can also write your answer down in your notebook. Some examples are strength, time, and money. Anyone else have any other ideas other than Hannah?
Money.
Anyone else?
Love.
Love, yeah. Harmony, you have anything? Yeah, that's a good guess. You can give yourself Harmony and Hannah candy for that.
Gaining skills.
Yeah.
Gaining talents, actually.
That's a good guess. You can give Alex the candy, too, for answering that. What are some specific ways you can use these gifts for Jesus? Anyone have any guesses?
Oh.
You have any guesses, Beth?
I could play a game really.
Yeah. If you have lots of money, you could give it to the poor. Sophia, could you also give one to Beth, too?
Which one do you do?
All right. Doing good things with the gifts God has given us is not for our glory. So if we do good things, it's not for our glory, but it's to our benefit. The goal is not to gain praise from other people, but to hear Jesus say this to us one day. Well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over few things. I will make you rule over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord. Just like how that ruler over those servants responded when they were faithful and they gained more talents. He was like, well done, good and faithful servants. And we want Jesus one day to say that to us. So we need to try our best to be faithful to him. Now everyone stand up. It's prayer time. All right. Lord, faith is a fruit of the Spirit, so we know we need the Holy Spirit working in our lives in order to be truly faithful. Fill us with your Spirit. Help us to be faithful with the things you have given us while we wait for you to return. In Jesus' name, pray, and everyone say, Amen.
Amen.
All right, so today we're going on to class now. So this week, read through Hebrews 11, and you can either write that down on your phone or write that down on your notebook to read through Hebrews 11. Take time to research the lives of some people mentioned in the chapter. Learning more about people of great faith will help you your faith grow. So if you want your faith to grow, do that. Now we are going on to our praise, and we're gonna listen to a little song here. Could I have somebody turn off the lights?
A widow song.
Thank you, Alex. And you can praise the Lord as we listen to the song. Is the sound not working?
No, remember you have to
turn on the volume on here. Just give me a minute here. How do you do that again?
So the speakers aren't working.
Yeah.
So you have to, what did we do last time?
I'm trying to remember.
We went into the settings.
Yeah. Try to find that.
So if you scroll down here.
Okay. Settings. Right there.
Mm-hmm. Go into sound. And internal speakers built in.
Should be good.
I think.
Alright, we're gonna try and play the song now. There we go. And you can also sing along with the song if you want to.
Oh God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions they fail not. As thou hast been, thou I
we're going on to announcements before we go on to our game. So if you want to give money to move the missions, or if you want to give money to move the missions, you can hit your name on this paper here and how much money you'd like to give. And Move the Mission provides grants for up to $25,000 to assist North American missionaries in purchasing property or remodeling an existing building. And we are about to watch a short video on what Move the Missions did for somebody here. So we are going to watch that.
My name is Trey Cornwell. I am from Wichita, Kansas, and I am the chapter leader of Aftershock Student Ministries, which is founded at Wichita State University. In 2020, I had the privilege and the honor of attending CMI Awakening on the University of Illinois. There, God began to pour out kingdom burdens and kingdom visions in my life. I had no intention of being a campus minister, but when I heard the call of God, I knew it was time for me to move the mission. Move the Mission makes it possible for campus ministers and all those that want to be a soul winner to gather together and to celebrate each other's ministries, to celebrate each other's campuses, and to celebrate the outpouring of the Holy Ghost that is destined for our college universities. April 18th, 2023, Aftershock Student Ministry was able to have an apostolic red-hot service in the middle of Wichita State University. There, over 100 college students would gather together. Over 40 would declare and testify of notable miracles in their life, including 3 college students who made the decision to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of all of their sins. Move the Mission has cultivated purpose on my campus. I want to give a great shout out to every campus minister who has put their hand in the field and has put their hand to the plow and has not turned back. Because of Move the Mission, I have become a campus minister. It's time to move the mission. What campus is next?
And I'm going to be talking about this till the end of the school year. And before we get into our game, I have one more announcement. So our last P7 club meeting is coming up for this school year. The last one is going to be on June 6th, so we have about 2 more meetings after this. And we will be having games, pizza, yum yum. So make sure to invite your friends so they can join in having pizza. So if you'd like to invite any friends, you can take one of these cards and invite them to come and enjoy some pizza and some fun with us. And we also have drinks like iced tea and stuff, which you guys, I know you guys love to death. And then we're going to have Q&A. How that's going to work is on these little cards I handed out here, you guys are going to write questions you have about the Bible, about lessons we learned. In our last meeting, we're not going to say who asked the question, but we're going to like have me sit up here, and if Sophia or Hannah want to help answer some of the questions, they can. But I'm going to have you guys fill out these cards with any questions from the Bible or from lessons we learned, and we will have a little Q&A and we will answer those questions. So make sure to invite your friends to that last meeting because it's going to be lots of fun. And we're also going to have a slideshow which will go over some of the fun things we had this year. So make sure to definitely invite people to that. And I'm going to give you guys a few minutes to put a question in here. So you guys can go ahead and write questions on those little cards I gave you. While you do that, I'm just going to walk around the room and come and gather up the questions. And after that, Hannah is going to be leading a game. So make sure to get those questions on so we can get into the game.